Hi, good morning. Welcome to SSV AIT classes. I am Basha, faculty of maths. Analytical geometry about 8th class students. In previous class, we discussed about the transformation of axes. Means there are two transformations. One is translation of axes and other one is rotation of axes. Yesterday we discussed about the translation of axes. What is a translation of axes? When the two coordinate axes are without changing the direction, we are shifting the origin to another distinct point. Then finding the coordinates of a point which is in the plane. Now we are going to find the rotation of axis. What is a rotation of axis? Rotation of axis means, and similarly we are finding the, without changing the position of the origin, we are changing the direction of the two coordinate axis is known as a rotation of axis. Means, let us here observe. These are the two coordinate axes, x and y. X and y origin. And I am shifting the two coordinate axes, making a distinct angle with respect to the original axis. Means, origin is not changing. Here I am changing the direction x dash, making an angle theta with the original axis. Similarly, a perpendicular line to the x dash gives us y dash, which make the same angle theta with the y axis. Means, without changing the position of the origin, we are rotated the axis x and y, making an angle theta. Let us mark a point P on the plane which gives the coordinate x comma y with respect to the previous axis, means x and y axis, and which gives the new coordinate axis also P x dash comma y dash with respect to the x dash o y dash. Let us draw perpendiculars from P to the x and the x dash. First of all, I am constructing a perpendicular to x axis which will be L, and draw another perpendicular to x dash which gives us M, and M is the point of intersection from PM to x dash axis. From again here we are drawing a perpendicular from M to the x axis, original axis, like it will be N, and draw a horizontal line to x axis from M to intersect the PL at the N. Means it is horizontal, means here we get a perpendicular symbol because of L is perpendicular, N is perpendicular, here M also perpendicular, PM perpendicular to x axis. Observe, in triangle ONM or MNO, we have a right angle. It is theta, so this is 90 minus theta. Similarly, MON and PMN are similar triangles based on 190 degrees, and automatically this will become theta, this will become 90 minus theta. So then, triangle MNO similar to triangle PMN. Then, from these two triangles, we will find the values of x and y coordinates of P. Let us, I am writing here, observe, OL. OL is equal to coordinate of P, x coordinate x. And x dash means OM. OM is equal to x dash. What about y? Y means, observe, it is PL is equal to y. PL is equal to y. And y dash. Y dash means PM is equal to y dash. PM is equal to y dash. From these three values, we will find x and y, x dash and y dash values. Observe, therefore, x is equal to, from here to, from the diagram, what is x? Coordinate of P, x coordinate. So here already we wrote x is equal to OL will be written as O ON minus LN minus LN. But we don't know LN value. Again ON minus LN. LN will be written as MN because of these two parallel and also equal MN. MN. So we are finding the ON and the MN values from two triangles MNO and PMN. So here in triangle MNO, MNO, this is the theta. So we want ON value. ON means adjacent we have. So in triangle MNO, cos theta is equal to adjacent ON by hypotenuse OM. So ON is equal to OM cos theta, that is equal to ON. What is OM value? X dash. X dash cos theta is equal to ON. Means ON is equal to X dash cos theta. Minus what about MN value? MN. MN means in triangle MPN, it is the adjacent side. With respect to theta, it is opposite. Means in triangle MPN. M P N. So I am writing here theta is there, means opposite we want. Sin theta is equal to MN by PM. MN by PM. So PM sin theta is equal to MN. So MN is equal to PM. What is PM value? PM is equal to Y dash. Y dash sin theta is equal to PM, means Y dash sin. It is known as x coordinate value with respect to the original system. Similarly, we will find the y coordinate with respect to the original system by using the same these two triangles, MNO and MPN. So let us, y is equal to, so already we got y is equal to PL. PL coordinate. PL distance will be y. PL is equal to, PL is a summation of PN plus NL. PN plus NL. PN plus NL. So here PN will be adjacent side of PMN triangle. We don't know NL value, so it will be compared with MN. MN. So I am writing here PN plus NL is equal to MN. MN. So same in triangle MNO, in triangle MNO, I am writing the value of MN. MN means opposite to theta. So sin theta is equal to, we want to choose sine. MN by OM, opposite by hypotenuse. MN by OM. So OM sin theta is equal to MN. OM value already wrote here, x dash. X dash sin theta is equal to MN. Similarly, we want to find PN. PN in MPN triangle. PN, which is adjacent to the theta. Adjacent means MNP triangle. So we want cos theta is equal to, here we have theta. Cos theta means adjacent by hypotenuse. PN by MP. PN by MP. So MP cos theta is equal to PN. What is MP or PM value? Here we wrote PM is equal to Y dash. Y dash cos theta is equal to PN. By substituting these two values in the equation, Y is equal to PN. Y dash cos theta plus MN. X dash sin theta. These are the two values of x and y coordinates. This is the equation 1 which gives us x coordinate, and this is the equation 2 which gives us y coordinate. By solving or by arranging the term 1 and 2, we will get the x dash and y dash values also. X dash is equal to x cos theta plus y sin theta, and y dash is equal to minus x sin theta plus y cos theta. So these are the new coordinates of P with respect to the new axis, and x and y, these are the original coordinates of P with respect to the original axis. These two values we will find by using this table, means by using x cos theta minus sin theta, y sin theta cos theta, x dash and y dash. We want to find x value, means x is equal to, observe, we want to compare these two, x dash cos theta minus y dash sin theta, y is equal to x dash sin theta plus y dash cos theta. So we want to find x dash value. What about x dash is equal to, by like this, x cos theta plus y sin theta. What about y dash value? Minus x sin theta plus y cos theta. So this is a simple form to remember the x dash and x values of P with respect to the new and original coordinate axis. We'll go for one example based on these concepts. Find the coordinates of P 1 comma 2 with reference to new axis when the axis rotated at angle 30 degrees. Means the given P is 1 comma 2, which gives us x comma y, and the angle is 30 degrees, theta is equal to 30 degrees, with reference to new axis. New axis means we want to find the x dash and y dash values. So what is the x dash formula? By table we will write x dash is equal to x cos theta plus y sin theta. X cos theta plus y sin theta, by substituting x and y theta values, x means 1, y means 2, 1 cos 30 plus 2 sin 30. Cos 30 value root 3 by 2 plus 2, sin 30 value 1 by 2, to cancel, or we can write root 3 by 2 plus 1, or without cancelling 2 we will write root 3 plus 2 by 2. So we can write this one or this one, any one of the solution. Similarly, y dash is equal to, here we have a table, y dash is equal to minus x sin theta plus y cos theta, minus x sin theta plus y cos theta, then minus 1, x means 1, sin 30 plus y means 2 cos 30, minus 1 sin 30 value 1 by 2 plus 2 cos 30 value root 3 by 2. So by taking 2, minus 1 plus 2 root 3 by 2 is the y dash values, which gives us the P x dash y dash with respect to the new coordinate system will be root 3 plus 2 by 2 comma minus 1 plus 2 root 3 by 2 with the new coordinate axis. Today we discussed about the rotation of axis. What is mean by rotation of axis? Means the coordinate axis are rotating with respect to an angle without changing the origin, is known as a rotation of axis. There we are finding the a point P coordinates with respect to the new and original axis. The values of x and y, x dash and y dash values give this table, and this is the one example for based on this concept. Thank you for watching.